some instructions about the tom gongs. The three tom gongs fit into each other, so be careful not to scratch the outer ones with the screws of the one you move. So here the tom gong, there's a hole at the bottom where you can put the handle in. One handle is for holding it by hand. Now you push the handle in quite firmly. And the connecting piece is made of rubber, so it holds the tom gong, but it doesn't dampen the stone. You strike the tongs about in the middle, a little above the middle of their length. That's the best sound. Take this out again by just pulling it out. It goes in about half an inch, 1 centimeter. Another stand is for putting it on a table or a surface. Again, you push it in quite firmly, stand it like that, and then you play it. So here's the hole again in the bottom of the tom gong in which the connecting piece for the stands come in. So you simply insert the rubber stop into it and then push it in pretty hard so that it doesn't fall off. Sometimes you need to tighten the screws that hold the tongs onto the body. For instance, if it sounds like this. So this doesn't sound all that great. You put the tongue on a soft surface, like with a towel, I use it here. You take the screwdriver, you need a number 2 Phillips head screwdriver for this. Hold it vertically, hold it tight, and then tighten it. Just use the normal full hand power. And now it sounds great again. So tuning and replacing the tongs. You can see that the tongs are held onto the body with the 2 screws and they rest on 2 round rods and they supply the supporting points for the tongs. So the length that the tong sticks out from the top support determines the tuning. Let's suppose we want to change this one. First you release the screw, so now it can move freely. You can even take it out. And here are the 2 supports, the rods. Now, to mount the tong, it has to go underneath the washer. So easiest way is to hang it upside down and then it can slide under the washers. Then you put the supporting rods in place, and at first they will just be at the kind of outside, but at about equal distance from the middle where the screws are. And well, basically you just tighten the screws again, tighten them good, and it's mounted again. Now, how to tune it. On each tong I've made some indications of the tunings. These are just indications because it depends also on the tuning of the other tongs and on whether you have the small bass or the larger bass, so it can vary a little bit, but it gives you an idea. So let's see, we have a keyboard here. How was this tuned? Let's take this one up. It's now about F. Let's take it to G. So it has to go up a little. It means the tongue has to be shorter. I release this screws, and now I kind of can do two things. The tongue can slide up and down a bit, so I slide it down so it becomes shorter. And also the supporting rod can move in and out. And I need to go to G, so about at the top. It's a little low still, so the supporting rod can go up a little bit. That's pretty good. So each tongue has its own range over which it can be tuned, and the long tongues they have a short range of about a third, so three whole tones. The middle range you get about a quart, four tones, and for the shortest and highest tongues they can be tuned over a range of a fifth, so you have quite a variety of tones there. Now I'll show you, we're going to put on a tongue so you can remove them and you get a few extra ones so you can get the tuning that you want. And we'll tune it and then we'll fine tune it. So the tongue has to go under the washers, not like this. And I already showed the trick to do it upside down. You can also just lift the washers by hand and insert them like this. So there. Then again we'll put on the supporting rods, which determine the actual length. Now I'll show this way. So the range of the tuning is determined the when the rods are the farthest and the tine is the deepest in. It's pretty hard without support. So now the tongue is the shortest and you get the highest note, and the other way around. If you want the tongue the lowest, you want it to stick out the most, and the rod goes a bit deeper. It is important that you have the two supporting rods kind of like at equal distance from the screws. So they're kind of like the same space, the screws in the middle. Now let's tighten it. I'll just take any tuning and then we'll fine tune it. Let's see what we have now. So these are almost the same, it's about an A. So let's tune this one up. So we want to go up, so the length has to be shortened so the tongue goes deeper. Maybe we try around here. You tighten it good and strong, so you're going to get extra noises. It's a little high. Let's aim for the C. This is C. And now it's C sharp. So it has to. We need a little more length. I move the rod out this way. No. I make it longer, sorry. So I go this way. it's not very equal, so I move the whole thing so they're about equally spaced. Next, important that the rod is kind of like parallel with the base of the tongong. I'm a little low now. Can tighten it. That's actually pretty good. Tighten it some more to get rid of the extra noises. Now, of course, it is very hard to get it very precise in this way, so there's a little trick. So you notice this tone, the tone A. It's a little sharp. And that's a good thing, because we can fine-tune the tongs by applying some wax. This is sculptor's wax, beeswax. And what I usually do is I tune my tongs a little higher frequency than the intended pitch. Then I apply this wax to the back, to the inside of the tongue. This gives some extra mass to the tongue and it lowers the pitch. So now it's good. I don't know if you can hear the difference. I'll take it off. So it just lowers it a little bit. If you need to lower it more, you can apply even two. You can even do a little more of the wax on the tongs, but not too much, because that will dampen the sound. So I include this wax with the tongong set, and this is the easiest way to very precisely tune your tongs. So I'll demonstrate again the fine tuning with the wax. Here I have the note C. So it's a little sharp. So I bring down the tuning with applying these little blobs of wax. If it's cool, you have to kind of like knead them a little bit to make them more malleable. This was the tone. So I stick the wax onto the back of the tongue. That's the tuning. Now this tuning works only to lower the pitch, so if it's a bit too low, so this tone is too low, so I first have to raise it. I have to tune it a little bit over the specified frequency, and then I can tune it down with the wax. So again, I loosen the tongue. I shorten the length very slightly. I tighten the tongue in using some good force. It's good already, so you don't even always need it. Let's see how the other one's doing. One is good. Also good. It's a little high, but I guess it can work. So what I usually do is I have first some plan or idea about the tuning. So then I see if all the forget the right tongs for that. Otherwise, I can exchange the tongs for the unused ones. I usually have my tuning arranged counterclockwise from low to high, but of course you're free to change that. You can go the other direction or just have them randomly distributed. And for multiple tongs, you kind of find the tuning with some of the tones in common and others different. Let's tune this one a bit. So this one is pretty high. Let's see if we can get it down using the wax again. You probably need two blobs of wax. You can hear the difference. So this is with the wax. Without it. So you have a range of, well, it's less than a half tone, but it's good enough for fine tuning. Now, using the hand handles is an interesting effect. I'm gonna show you how to push it in. It takes quite some force because you don't want it to fall off. So it goes in about half an inch. Now, interesting is that if you move it while playing, you get a kind of a lively effect by rolling it around while playing. Now, the tong drum by itself, when you put it on the table without the support, it will kind of like sound a bit dampened. And so that's why I included these stands with the little rubber supports that supports the tong drum, but it doesn't dampen the sound. So each tong drum has its own stand included, and you can configure it however you want on your table. But I'm also including a triple stand to which will hold all three of the tong drums at the same time. Consists of two pieces of wood. It's pretty simple, actually. You can take them apart with the screw here, and you can set them at a different distance. You can release these rubber stops and move them in or out a bit if you wish to. So then you can mount all the three tong drums on one stand. Okay. Use some force so you don't want it to drop off. One here. And again, you can choose how you want to configure it. Here. So by using the different positions, you could have them a little closer together if you wanted to. This away. And this whole contraption you can put on a stand, like a percussion stand or a strong microphone stand. It's not so light. It's about 6 or 7 kilos, I think, in total. So be careful you don't drop the whole thing. So I use this very flimsy small stand. It's actually a sheet music stand, and and with a little attachment, because it's not normal for supporting instruments. So there's a screw here. So let's try this. Maybe a bit of light. So we have the triple stand with a hole in the middle. I put the screw through it. I hope it's not going to fall apart here. Tighten it with a wing nut. Now, there is a triple tongue.